Hello everyone, as we have started the states of matter topic, in that we have seen that introductory part as well as we have completed that laws also. Charles law, Boyle's law, Avogadro's law, Gay-Lussac's law also we have completed. Now it's time to discuss the ideal gas equation. Before going towards that ideal gas equation or what is that equation, I want to tell you what is meant by that ideal gas. So now see here, ideal gas. Listen carefully. Ideal gas is a hypothetical. Hypothetical means it is a imaginary. Hypothetical gaseous substance. Hypothetical gaseous substance. In that we can say that according to ideal gas, that point, ideal gas in which there is a no intermolecular force means there is a no attraction as well as no repulsion, like that, that point is there. So in that we can say that ideal gas is a hypothetical gaseous substance in which, or which is not depend on the, in which no attractive and repulsive forces, attractive and repulsive forces. But in real, there is a no such a gas is there. But as we know that when we are in a worse situation, at that time we can compare our situation that yes, previously we were in the good situation. Like that means for the comparison purpose, we can say that for the conceptual purpose, this ideal gas is there. So if we having any real gas means nowadays not, as we are having the number of gases, these are the real gases. So properties or some points we can compare of the real gases with the ideal gas. For that purpose, we are going to consider that ideal gas. Now it's time to discuss what is that ideal gas equation. As we know that Boyle's law. Second one is the Charles law. Next one is the Avogadro's law. Okay. So all these law are combined in a single equation. They combine together in a single equation, and that equation is called as a ideal gas equation. So now we are going to discuss. See, what is the point? Boyle's law, Charles law, Avogadro's law are combined together in a single equation. It is called as a ideal gas equation. So for that purpose, we are going to make one table. So in that table, which law we are going to consider, what is constant? Everyone has completed these notes? Hope so, everyone has completed. If not completed, please note down all these notes also. Is that table? Table is, firstly we are going to consider the law. Which law we are going to consider? For this law, what is the constant term? We will write in a second column, and in a third column, equation of that law. That in this way we will draw one table. Now see here, firstly we are going to consider that ideal gas equation is the combination of the three laws. Which law? First one is a Boyle's law, second one is a Charles law, and third one is a Avogadro's law. So all these law I have written in a column. So for the Boyle's law, what is the constant? Constant is temperature and number of moles, means amount of a gas. In a Charles law, what is the constant? Constant is the pressure and number of moles, means fixed amount of gas is there. That's why N is constant. Avogadro's law. For that one, if we consider Avogadro's law, in that we can say that volume is directly proportional to the number of moles. Means here, we can say that temperature and pressure, these two terms are the constant. Charles law, pressure and number of moles are constant. Means here, that formula is volume is directly proportional to the temperature. And in the Boyle's law, at constant temperature for a fixed amount of gas, volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. Understood? So here we have completed this table. So hope so everyone understood that. Now we are going to combine all these gases. If we combine all these three gases in a one equation, then V was the common. For example, V is inversely proportional to P. V is directly proportional to T. V is directly proportional to N. All these three laws we are going to combine here. So, volume is directly proportional to N and T. So, N, T divided by. Why divided by? Because in a Boyle's law, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. So, this is the one equation we got. To remove that proportionality sign, we are using one constant, that is the R, N, T divided by P. So, this is the final equation. In that, this R is a gas constant. This R is called as a gas constant. The value of, what is the point? Listen carefully. If we consider the value of this R, every time we are using that value of R is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. So, this constant value is same for all the gases. That's why this gas constant is also called as a universal gas constant. What is point? The value of R, that is nothing but the gas constant, is same for all the gases. So it is also called as universal gas constant. So here we can say that we have completed that starting part of the ideal gas equation. How this value of R is calculated, that part also we are going to discuss. So for that one, now see here. Here if we consider how that R is equal to 8.314 will come. As we know that this equation, if we are just simply modifying that, what will be the equation? PV. Just we are shifting that P to the left side. So, PV is equal to nRT. This PV is equal to nRT. It is called as a ideal gas equation. This PV is equal to nRT is called as a ideal gas equation. By using this formula only, we are going to calculate the value of R. Now, see here. Pressure, for that one, firstly we are going to consider standard condition, that is of the temperature and pressure. What is the standard temperature? Previously also we have seen that standard temperature is 273.15 Kelvin. Standard pressure is 1 bar. Okay, now see here. At standard condition of the temperature and pressure, volume of 1 mole of gas, volume of 1 mole of gas at STP is 22.71. Volume of 1 mole of gas at STP is 22.71. Its unit is liter per mole. Means it is given in the liter. So firstly we have to convert into the meter cube. So for that one, we have to just multiply with the 10 raised to minus 3. So, finally, we will get that value if we are putting all this in this one. Now, see here. Volume, it is equal to 22.71. It is in the liter per mole into 10 raised to minus 3. It will come meter cube per mole. Okay. Volume is completed. In that, PV is equal to nRT. Volume completed. What about the pressure? Pressure is 1 bar. Number of moles is 1 mole of gas. So, it is also 1. R we have to find out, and T is 273.15 Kelvin. Now finally, R is equal to, if we modify this equation, then what will happen? R is equal to PV divided by NT. What is the value of P? It is the 22 point sorry P is 1 into volume is 22.71 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 1 into 273.15. After this calculation, we will get the answer, and that answer will be 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Hope so everyone understood that calculation part also. Now we will discuss, if we consider As we have seen that previously, in the gas, if we have taken gas in a container, everyone has completed this part. Now see next point. Next part is that if we have taken a gas of a fixed amount of gas means what will be constant? N will be constant, means at constant volume, at constant N. If volume of that gas is V1, pressure is P1 and temperature is T1, that changes to V2, P2, T2. So as we know that ideal gas equation, in that if we consider PV is equal to nRT, this is the ideal gas equation. Now here N is constant, R is also constant. If we are taking PVT for the first initial state and the final state, then what will be the formula? Then the formula will be P1V1 is equal to nRT1. Second one, P2V2 is equal to nRT2. Now in this way, if we are shifting T2 this side, T1 to this side, then what will be the equation? Equation will be P1V1 divided by T1 is equal to nR. P2V2 divided by T2 is equal to nR. Means from these two equation, we can write the equation, that is formula, that is the P1V1 divided by T1 is equal to P2V2 divided by T2. So this equation is called as a combined gas equation. Understood? Firstly, we have seen that ideal gas equation, and after that, when that fixed amount of volume of a gas changes, at that time we got another one equation, that is the combined gas equation. So here we have completed some part related to ideal gas equation. Based on this formula as well as this formula, we will complete the numerical part also. Thank you all of you.